if you're in the other room, come take a part of this interview. I'm very honored today. You ever wonder what it's like to live in space? Well, astronaut Koichi Wakata, a commander, commanded the space station for almost 11 months as it orbited around the Earth, and he's here in Hawaii to share his experience at the 15th annual Ellison Onizuka Science Day. Commander Wakata, thank you so much for coming here. You know, as a young child growing up in Hawaii, Ellison Onizuka was an inspiration. And what is it like for you, sir, to come to Hawaii and speak and interact with the kids here?
Exactly. Ellison is my inspiration as well. And I saw the Apollo 11 landing when I was 5 years old.
Wow.
I thought it was impossible as a Japanese small boy to go to space because at that time they were only American mm-hmm. and Russian cosmonauts. And Ellison, as the first Japanese descendant person to fly in space, he inspired me and a lot of people in Japan too.
I didn't know that. I didn't realize that. But when you put that together, and I got to ask, sir, what was it like to be the first Japanese commander of the space station? I mean, that's a lot of responsibility. And you almost spent a year in space. What's that like living there?
Yeah, it's a wonderful place, and it's great to work with so many dedicated people from all over the world, from U.S., Russia, Canada, European nations, and Japan. So I feel so fortunate to be able to work in this international team.
You know, now that you're back here on Earth, what's it like to come and talk to some of the students? I know you're here in Hawaii. To be able to touch base with the students and maybe you inspiration for the next generation of young astronauts, well, what's that like for you, sir?
Exactly. As Ellison inspired me and a lot of youngsters at the time, I'm taking the role of sharing this excitement to the youngsters in human space exploration and in science.
Do the young kids now, everybody's got iPads and all computer, are they more technologically inclined? I mean, what's it like with the kids nowadays?
I think so. They will be a better operator of, for example, robotics because they're so good at the playing games.
Mm-hmm.
But still, this excitement of going to space is the same, you know, no matter when we are and how old we are.
That's so great. Yeah. I can see the excitement in you. I got to ask a couple questions. And again, it's an anniversary today of a fortunate, tragic space event. And we actually had you talking right here, some B-roll, some of the students. But on social media this morning, we actually had one question come. I mean, you're on a rocket with thousands of pounds of fuel heading off towards space. Are you ever scared? I mean, you're in a place that very few humans go. Do you ever get scared?
Yeah, actually, my first flight was in January of 1992. Mm-hmm. I still remember the Challenger accident. It's almost 6:26, but it was exactly 29 years ago, 6:38 Hawaii time in the morning when we had this Challenger accident. So, yes, when I see my colleagues going up, because I cannot do anything for the launch, just looking at on the ground,
mm-hmm.
I think I feel the risk more. And especially for the family members, I think it's going to be tough. But do we go to space? It's a risky business, and there's dangerous moments, but we go space because we can learn and gain more than the risk that we take. So I am glad to be part of this.
Well, we're glad to have you part of us representing mankind and the human race
Thank
as
you.
We head to space. Again, he's going to be in town talking to students. If you can, get over to the Ellison Onizuka Museum over on the Big Island. It's a wonderful museum. It's a part of American and Hawaii and worldwide history. So again, Koichi-san, thank you so much.
Thank you very much. We are honored
for having you here today, and especially carrying mankind's journey from the world back to Hawaii and inspiring the next generation.